And Hogwarts Legacy is officially the number one single-player game ever on Twitch with 1.28 million peak concurrent viewers at launch. According to Hogwarts Legacy Gold Check account, everybody's raving about this game, or at least saying it's pretty good. Even the Metacritic scores are pretty good, even from outlets that really weren't on board with the game initially because of J.K. Rowling mm-hmm. and her views. Except for Wired. Wired gave it a 1 out of 10. A 1 out of 10. And the reason...
So you just told everybody, Wired, that your journalistic integrity is not there because you did not fairly review it. You used it instead for political activist whatever points.
Yes.
Instead of actually doing your job as a journalist, which is, you know, to be honest.
How long is this journo actually going to be working for Wired? It's 1 out of 10. They said the game is mid at best. Even if it's mid, it should have gotten a 5 out of 10, right?
Mm-hmm.
1 out of 10 is like Superman 64 levels of bad.
Well, you read this stuff too. It's clearly they've been on Twitter, they're on these groups, it's the same talking points. They honestly, I don't know how journalists can't think for themselves, that only can just repeat bad, stuff they hear without actually looking into it.
Using Twitter, which is owned by a toxic cis billionaire with problematic views, mm-hmm. we're gonna talk about this because I'll be honest, I expected a lot more reviews like this. I expected a lot of reviews like this, and the reason this review exists, of course, to drag down the score on Metacritic.
If you don't mind, it only happens when the other side does it. Whether that is, because you can still be clearly on the same side as them, but the other side, if you don't agree with them.
The other side. So we're going to take a look at this. It seemed like every journo that reviewed it that worked for the established gaming, approved gaming media list, had that disclaimer.
They're afraid their friends are all going to turn on them and stuff. They're afraid of the mob, which we said was going
to
happen.
Yeah, they said that. There was actually one reviewer that was like, yeah, I was kind of afraid to play it because I knew what was going to happen if I did. They were calling out IGN for daring to review it. Like, IGN's one of the biggest game sites on the internet.
But you know what? To do it, even though you know it could lead to you getting canceled or other things because you know it's your job to do it, I respect that. Because that takes courage at least.
Yeah.
I mean, this is just bullshit.
So through this ridiculous non-review, this is just an activist giving high fives to their friends on Twitter and etc. Coming from Wired, which used to be reputable, and it clearly is not now.
It hasn't been for a while, has it?
No. Jana Gray. Review. There is no magic in Hogwarts Legacy. The game is mid at best. Okay, 5 out of 10, right? And its real-world harms are impossible to ignore. I expected a 5 or 6.
How specifically is this game real-world harming people? Because J.K. Rowling, who had nothing to do with this game, said some things.
Yes.
That you don't like.
Yes.
And I'm sorry. I don't agree with everything J.K. Rowling said, but you know. I don't want to be called a menstruating person. I want to be called a woman. So I don't disagree with her on that. I mean, even people that are trans don't want to be called a trans woman. They want to be called a woman. So I would, you know, I don't feel any different.
Yeah, I know. It's
doesn't do anything.
Right. There is a trans character in the game, and you can play as trans characters in the game. And they made statements that they, the development team really didn't have a lot of contact with her during the process, any more than the Lego people have any contact with her. They're just based in a set of movies. Wired. It said it helped the pros and cons. Right. It helped me say goodbye to the setting for good.
Good. I'm glad you're gone.
Yeah, right?
Come on, the
door to MES! The story is rooted in anti-Semitic tropes. The gameplay feels dated. The graphics feel like they're a couple generations behind. The characters are one-dimensional. Doesn't stay true to the original lore. Every character feels like an off-brand version of characters we know and love. There's no sense of place, no magic, no heart.
I don't think you're right. I think you're supposed to say that they didn't think that they're anti-Semitic tropes. So
I guess that's your...
Are we talking
about the goblins?
I'm sorry.
Okay, so here's the thing, about the whole goblin situation in Harry Potter. The goblins have been represented on screen for over 20 years. Nobody complained about the goblins until they decided they didn't like J.K. Rowling. I'm just saying. They've been there forever, and nobody was complaining about it until they decided they didn't like J.K. Rowling.
Right? And then it's the gameplay feels dated. Now, goblins have said that it did feel dated. Some places mentioned that as well. The graphics are a couple generations behind. Yes, but it's a game they developed for how long? Every time it's upgraded, the product could start all over again. You know what I mean? Characters are one-dimensional, but the writer's an expert on that.
Or at least attempt to get a fair review, we're gonna get somebody else who will. Or if you're gonna publish this shit, you're fired. Because this right here, you have basically just set a flare up to the entire internet that Wired cannot be trusted for anything because it's not even remotely close to being fair. You're flying. This is not gonna be a fair review. She's written, but before the Hogwarts Legacy review, which is making rounds, by the way, they're pulling it into here's 8 best vibrators, 7 best Valentine's Day sex toy deals, more sex toys, camera accessories, Nintendo Switch games, espresso, weighted blankets.
Yeah.
Journalism is embodied in that.
Watching, and we'll see you in the morning. MAGA.